Hello, lovely people. We're on a vegetable farm today, and I want to show you this corn. Come. This area of corn is positively buzzing with bees because these are flowers of corn. Male flowers are dropping pollen left and right. If you think I'm mildly obsessed with corn because I'm talking about it all the time, I am. The way they reproduce is so unique and so mind-blowing, and this is like the perfect time to see it, so I just wanted to show it to you. Come close. These are the male flowers. This is where the pollen is coming from, and I'll show you in a minute how there are bees buzzing around. Not this one because I'm scaring them away right now, but this pollen is dropping. You can kind of see. Look, I'm gonna get it on my finger. Can you see that? There is pollen all over on these leaves. And where the pollen's supposed to go, follow me down, is here. This is your baby ear of corn, right? This is the female part. And all this hair, right? All this corn silk. Look how much is sticking out right now, right? There's far less. By the time it matures, it'll be just about that much. But all of this is catching the pollen. The pollen raining down, catching on this silk, and as you know, from previous episodes, that these are actually tubes. This silk leads, they're sticky, they have hairs, and they catch the pollen, and they lead the pollen down into the ear of corn to fertilize each little individual kernel. That's how it happens, folks. If you get a kernel and it's not fully, if it's not full of kernels, no, if you get an ear and it's not full of kernels, it's because not enough pollen made it down to the ear and into the, or through the leaves that protect the ear. Crazy stuff, guys. Amazing.